go behind the scenes at the stadium's high-tech broadcast center.
Camera 7, pan in on Brady crying.
Experience video games played on the 200 by 36-foot video display.
Yeah!
Well, there's so many explosions.
Watch the guys run drills with former Raven Jarret Johnson.
Good Lord. Oh, my God.
Take a tour with Justin through M&T Bank Stadium.
Every single one of those pipes. Hot chocolate vouch.
All that plus our big moment with real fan Dan coming up next.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel?
The 98 Rock Morning Show?
Yep, I'm an idiot.
What is happening right now?
Pay me to talk!
What are they doing on my TV?
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV, the Monday Night Football edition.
Yeah, we're the flagship of the Baltimore Ravens, and they gave us unprecedented access to all their facilities.
Check it out.
Football, baby!
Football! Yeah. Get some! Yeah! And number 8! Number 8's coming for you! What you gonna do when Lamar runs wild on you?
Under Armour Performance Center, the castle where the Ravens train. We met up with number 95, Jarret Johnson, and he put us through the paces. We did some linebacker drills, and joining us on the phone to recap right now, Jarret Johnson. Good morning, Jarret.
Good morning, boys.
How are y'all feeling today?
Oh, my God.
I'm ready to die.
I'm fine.
I can't look left or right.
I'm so sore. I am so sore. I couldn't imagine doing this day in and day out.
I was eating Aleve like they were garbanzo beans last night. Everything sucks on my body.
You guys showed up, and, you know, I wanted to make sure you get the full effect, you know, to be able to go in the equipment room, meet Willie Sheridan, see all the gear. How cool is the equipment room? And you think it's all just an equipment room, just socks and jocks and stuff like that. No, it's top-notch, full-staff, professional seamstress that custom-fit the jerseys to the guys.
A giant cartoon-sized head. What size am I?
You were like a 7.5.
Is that average or above average?
Yeah, that's a little not average.
So I'm a football player.
Oh! Oh, my ears. Oh, God.
Okay, that's not bad.
Yeah, pull it down. There you go.
Okay. Is this the one Lamar uses?
No.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Ow!
Straight up in the
ooh.
Air.
Yeah. Ow. All right, almost. Okay.
There we go.
Oh, God. Oh, my goodness. Oh. 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 Oh.
It's like he's being bored.
I need some backup.
Come on.
Come on, fight through it.
Right from the warm-ups, let's start there. You know, we did a little high knees, a little karaoke, a little sidestep, whatever, back and forth.
Right.
And listen, we know you're a professional athlete, but the speed and the grace with what you, with what you, which you move is shocking.
Like
it was
a ballerina.
Shocking. And you weren't even, what were you going? I mean, it was like you took off. You're like, all right, ready, go. And he's like, he's gone.
Shot out of a can.
Gone.
All right, we are done for the day. That's it.
Started.
It felt good.
Just
we did
started.
Some high knees. What's that?
Just getting started.
Just getting started. That was a warm up.
Just warm up.
Just getting started. Okay.
Stay tuned.
Now it's hey. Now you can't even see you can't even see who you're dropping towards. Get your eyes. Get your eyes to your drop and then back to the quarterback.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV in prime time with one of the best to ever do it, Jarret Johnson here at the Under Armour Performance Center. What are we doing today?
I have no idea. He's going to put us through the paces. I'm a little bit scared.
He's going to shave our beard.
Yeah,
oh,
base linebacker drill, back drill. We're just going to weave through. You're going to get a good start. Get your hips down, back pedal back, explode forward. Go all the way through the bags. Little back pedal. Step over the bag and explode through the line. Go! Oh, I'm already hitting the bag. That was terrible.
Yeah, I was so bad.
That's actually pretty good.
Isn't it supposed to go in the front?
Yeah. Extremely slow, but not bad.
Hey!
Get your hips down. Good Lord. Oh my gosh. Get your hips down.
You're supposed to go in front, right?
What? Oh my God.
Go,
yeah, just run out there. It's fine. All right, you got to get your eyes back to the quarterback, okay?
You almost blew up Josh's spine with that pass. You
oh
threw
my God,
a
you
laser
throw,
at Josh's back.
Football, dude.
One more. You got one more.
One more.
One more. One more.
I don't want to get hurt. I don't want to get injured.
You have a helmet on. Down. Hey. Hey, you can't even see. You can't even see who you're dropping towards. Get your eyes. Get your eyes to your drop and then back to the quarterback.
Josh definitely struggled with just grasping the basic concepts of the game of football.
I do that with everything. I can't grasp the concept of anything.
But you were talking about Scott out there. You looked over at us and looked at Rick and the camera guy when Scott was out there going, we got a gamer out here.
Yeah, Scott, you could tell, had the pads on before. He definitely moved the best out of the three, you know, but still got a long way to go, but
of course. It's just we talked about it a little bit too. You know, like there's certain kids that grew up playing ball sports and certain kids that didn't, and it carries over into the adult life. Trust me, I'm so fat and out of shape, and I do not belong out there. But like the basics and the techniques that are still ingrained in you and stuff like that, where you can see like a Justin who hadn't played at all, didn't even really know just like the basic techniques.
You're gonna start out simulating being the tight end. I'm going to be the outside linebacker. One of the main blocks you get is just a base block. You're just going to come off the ball, fire at me. And as an outside linebacker, my target is your inside breastplate. So my eyes are going to be on your inside breastplate. With my inside hand, I'm going to step toward you and punch and extend my hand out and lock this arm down so you can't hold me and knock you in the backfield. And that's how you set the edge, is you set it with their body. And if you make the ball cut inside and then you shed underneath. Down, set, hike.
Good God.
Time out.
We got blood.
Jarrett Johnson's bleeding.
Time out. Jarrett Johnson's bleeding.
Jarrett Johnson's bleeding.
Jarrett Johnson's bleeding.
I made him bleed.
I made him bleed.
I made him bleed.
We made him bleed collectively. He's collectively bleeding. As a group. We made Jarrett bleed.
He's human.
I did that.
And there, Jarrett, I learned two things yesterday. One, if you're a quarterback that you're relying on me to defend you, you're a dead man. Second thing I realized that if you're a quarterback and I'm on the attack, you can spend all day in the pocket, text your friends, plan lunch. You have no reason to scramble. Justin ain't making it to you.
Oh,
did you let me tackle you when I blew your ACL out? I feel like you let the kid.
No, I didn't know. No, I did not. No clue you're going
to
do that.
He's not used to that in his entire career. That's never happened. The tight end just never wraps him up and tackles him.
I had no idea what I was doing.
Well, the tight end never had his legs wrapped around my hips, draping on my back.
Right.
This is so easy. It's not.
How did we do?
Stick with the radio, boys.
No good?
Not good.
Terrible. Give me some adjectives.
Small, slow, unathletic, stiff hips, slow-footed, soft.
Yes.
Everything.
Mm-hmm.
Up next.
We're about to go on the field. We're going out there for the Raven Salute the Service flag football game. I'm going to meet Millsy out on the field, and we're going to have some fun.
This is Justin Tucker of the Baltimore Ravens giving a massive shout out to Justin Scott and Spiegel, my favorite guys in the whole wide world, with the sickest radio show on planet Earth and beyond.
So at the Ravens-Texans game, they gave us unprecedented access to all the behind-the-scenes happenings at M&T Bank Stadium.
This is Steve Bisciotti's private elevator. That's right. He doesn't let anybody use this elevator except us and the Bisciottis.
What's that? That's not true? Everyone could use this? Okay, we got bad intel. Anybody could use this elevator. Every single one of those pipes, hot chocolate valves. They know it's winter. Bisciotti likes to take care of his fans. Those are 7,000 gallons per second of Swiss Miss hot chocolate. Those three, no marshmallow. Those three, marshmallow. Thank you, Steve. What's it? Not, that's not true? What is true? What is true? All I'm being is lied to today. Come on. That's a real Cushman. Yeah, you don't see that on the road anymore. That thing has got a hog in it. Two-cylinder. It actually runs on chicken broth. Top speed, 7 miles per hour. Cushman, the official vehicle of the 98 Rock Morning Show. This is it. We're about to go onto the field. I am Justin Schlegel from 98 Rocks. Justin Scott and Spiegel in the morning down here on the field, and it's time for Winning Moments sponsored by the Maryland Lottery. Are you ready to go? All right, here we go. Coming down in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it, Rosemary. Come on, keep going. Cheer for Rosemary. She's got this. Oh, come on, keep going. It's good. It's good. The Ravens have a $5,000 check for you, Rosemary.
We're about to go on the field. We're going out there for the Ravens Salute the Service flag football game. I'm going to meet Millsy out on the field, and we're going to have some fun. We got some great Ravens, former Ravens legends, players, and we got some veterans out here as well. Keith Mills, say hi to the people. Justin Scott Spiegel should be on TV. We're out here on the field. Here's our players. Look at these guys. What's the score?
1-0. Well, 7-0.
All right, 7-0, Millsy. 7-0. 7-0 green. 20 seconds. Can they score? Last play, last play. Touchdown, Jimmy!
We had a chance to stop by M&T Bank Stadium with the Ravens and do something very few people get to do.
They let us hook an Xbox and a Switch up to a 200-foot long HD screen.
And I don't even know what an Xbox is.
I got this. I got this. Come on. Here we go.
Oh, it's a kick! It's a fake! It's a fake! It's a fake! No! No!
Come on, Lamar. Come get a taste. Oh, yeah, baby! Yeah, man, I'm into it.
Are we playing?
Yes, we are.
Get up, yeah. Spiegel!
Oh, there's so many explosions.
So much stuff going on. Why does my character not seem to want to fight?
I'm the hyperactive little electronic kitten.
Spiegel, his controller is not even working.
Yeah,
get him!
My controller's not working.
No,
well.
His isn't. You
is
go get him.
Perfectly. That one. Get it.
Hit it.
Oh!
Easy, easy,
whoa.
Easy.
Whoa! Violence.
Don't break it.
Violence.
Up next.
I look to the Jumbotron, and there is Real Fan Dan. And who is with him?
Who?
But you two guys.
Yeah, yeah baby!
And it made my day.
The Ravens fans are a passionate bunch, and nobody more so than Real Fan Dan.
R-A-V-E-N-S. Ravens!
That's what that spells. We also took our shirts off. Sorry.
Third quarter.
Yeah.
I'm in the box with Jerry.
Jerry Sandusky. WBAL-TV.
It might have been the fourth quarter, actually. And Jerry is eloquently explaining something just poetic and beautiful, as he always does.
Right.
And I look to the Jumbotron, and there is Real Fan Dan getting this, getting the fans fired up.
Shout it's one of the greatest things in the stadium. Isn't that one of the greatest moments in the stadium every game?
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. And who is with him?
Who?
But you two guys.
Yeah, yeah baby!
And it made my day. I wanted to cuss so bad in a positive way.
We sit down in a meeting. And they start running down all these ideas, like, we could do this, we could do that. And we're all of a sudden, we're like, whoa, these are great ideas.
Yeah.
One of the ideas was like, hey, do the Ravens chant with Real Fan Dan. Yeah. I jump out of my seat. I'm like, hell yes.
That is a great
hell
idea.
Hell yes.
Yeah.
And it was the third quarter.
Third quarter.
Right after halftime. We got the ball in the second half.
Yep.
We were on the field at halftime, so we had to boogie all the way up to 532, his section. We, right as we're popping out of the tunnel, we scored.
Oh, the minute
we got the ball back,
there.
We drove down the field and we scored. The second we got there, we scored, and Dan's nowhere to be found.
Yeah, Dan was MIA. We think Dan was getting a pretzel.
Where was he?
We think he was getting a pretzel.
You think he was getting a pretzel or something? So we started asking everybody in the section. We're like, where's Dan? Where's Dan? They all know who he is because he's famous. They go, that's his seat right there. He sits right there. He'll be back. Sure enough, boom, he pops out. He goes, make way, boys. He gets in the middle. He's like, and we're like, I don't even think he knew who the hell we were or what we were doing there, but he didn't care. He's like,
stay out of Dan's
way. He decked me. He goes, you got to give me some room. Boom. And he like texts me. And I'm like, all right, dude, I'm going to be over here.
Yeah.
And we just kind of went with it. You do the first one. You know what happens with the first one, Jack?
What happens?
It's not good enough.
It's not good enough.
It's never good enough.
What's going to make it good enough?
When are the fans going to learn that the first time is never good enough?
You need to see our nipples.
And then that's when the shirts come off. Steroid riddle,
my weird navel and incapable of tanning skin. People are like throwing popcorn at us. Also, can I talk about that section? And I don't think I'm saying anything out of place here. The further you get down to the sidelines, it gets a little more well-to-do.
Pinkies up.
Up. Is there any chance I can get a Tom Collins for my mistress and I?
That's
but meanwhile,
why.
In the 500s, just chaos. People are just screaming, ripping their pants off.
I was up to the 500s a few games ago. If we go up to the 500s and we try to walk around that outer concourse, we can't walk 10 feet without being accosted because those are our people. It's insane
if
up there.
If I'm walking around...
Yeah, those are our people.
Those are real people, man.
Dude, those are real people. The 500 section is real people.
After we got done doing the real Fandan thing, we're trying to walk out of the tunnel back out into the concourse. We had to stop and take, I don't know, 10 selfies. It was great.
Coming up next.
This guy's going to give us a tour of these 8,000 screens, find out how this whole thing works, and the door code to get into is 1234. I shouldn't have said that. Come on in. I'm going to steal something.
We're here with Jay in the control room, M&T Bank Stadium, and as you can see, it's a pretty amazing place. How many seats we got in this room? How many people are in here on game day?
We have about 50 or so people working for us on game day, about 30 in the room, another 20 outside between camera folks, audio folks, folks that make you guys look and sound good for your two-minute warning hit. So that's got a lot of people making this show great.
What's the atmosphere up here like? I mean, is it exciting? Is it tense? I mean, you have to have stuff down to the millisecond.
Yeah, it depends on how things are going and on the field and how they're going up here technically. Certainly that Patriots game, we were all going nuts and having a blast up here.
All right, let's take a tour. Let's walk around a little bit.
Sure. So back here, this is replay row. So we have five replay operators. We're pulling in three. The first three are getting 4K, which just means like really, really high resolution. Those are the cameras that we can zoom in, you know, see if the foot was out of bounds, see if the guy made the catch, so we can zoom in without losing any, whatever.
Fantastic.
Then our last two are getting four cameras in, two cameras out in HD, so we're pulling in a lot of replays. We're recording 17 angles at one time.
Camera 7, pan in on Brady crying. There we go, good shot. Really zoom in on those tears. Nothing like seeing Brady cry in 4K. I shouldn't be touching this stuff. Hypothetically speaking, what would happen if someone wasn't paying attention and accidentally poured an entire cup of coffee into this pool?
Well, we have a strict no liquids policy on this counter for that exact reason.
So do we.
Yeah, and yet things happen, right?
Yes. Yes, they have.
How come everybody in racing?
Smoke! There's smoke!
Yeah, we're pretty lucky that... what you see right here is also duplicated right over there. So on the off chance, hypothetically, if this system were to go down, we'd be completely backed up and we'd be okay.
Jay, we've got access to all this amazing AV technology, high definition screens, surround sound, the likes of which the rest of the NFL is jealous of.
Yep.
Can we play one of our 98 Rock videos? Yeah.
You got it.
Let's do it. Boom.
Justin Schlegel, Waldorf Carpentry Institute. Scott Reardon, Parental Disappointment University.
Josh Spiegel, Kosher University.
Justin Schlegel, Wiccan Midwife Institute, Charles County, Maryland.
Scott Reardon, paralyzed with fear.
Josh Spiegel, looking out my Big News Window University.
Spiegel!
Thank you so much.